Good afternoon, everyone. It's my pleasure to be here today to have a conversation about what's new in HIV treatment and prevention for young people. I'm Anna Puga. I'm the global pediatric lead for ViiV Healthcare and a practicing physician in Florida in the United States. And I'm super happy to be in Cape Town on this topic and in such a beautiful place. I'm going to go through a few housekeeping slides and then just re-emphasize the importance of this population and then turn it over to our experts. And today, in addition to the faculty that we have up on the stage, we have some youth experts that will contribute to our presentation. So this is being recorded. When our youth comes up, I please ask that no photos be taken to respect her privacy. And also make sure that if you're asking questions, you use the microphone. We may discuss off-label issues, and so make sure you refer to your on-label instructions for products. And there, the evaluation that they send out at the end, we would love feedback on our symposia as well. So please complete your evaluation. If any side effects come up, we are prepared to report them because that is of utmost importance, that we report any safety issues. And we have ongoing projects within the continent on pharmacovigilance to further enhance those reports of adverse events and side effects. And I'll start with a couple minutes on epidemiology, and then Dr. Linda Stranix-Chivande will talk about prevention. We'll have a video expert, a young person who couldn't make it here, give her opinion on prevention in this population. And then Professor Philippa Musoke will speak on treatment, and our youth expert in the audience will come up and talk about her experience with treatment, and then we'll open for some questions. So you have our photography, and here are our disclosures. I'm an employee of ViiV Healthcare, and the presenters have received travel grants and or honoraria to present today. So I know this audience doesn't need me to go through the epidemic, but I think it grounds us in how serious it is. The situation with our young people and HIV. Over 1.75 million adolescents were living with HIV in 2020, and 160,000 new infections occurred in that year in individuals 10 to 19 years of age. And you see how it's not necessarily proportionately impacting all the continents, but this continent is definitely among the worst continents impacted by this pandemic. And then if you look at who are these young people, you see that 90% are in the continent of Africa and that the majority are young women. But although we've had some successes with some declines in Eastern and Southern Africa, we've had increases in other areas of Africa and the Middle East, but we still have over 1,000 new infections that occur every day in those 15 to 24 years of age. And of those, 61% are female. And I'll point to the top right of the slide, 25% of girls and 17% of boys in Eastern and Southern Africa have been tested. So we're missing a lot of young people in the testing arena. And so today's presentation about, you know, community and clinic testing and other ways to reach this population is of critical importance. And some of the reasons it may be more challenging obviously are related to stigma, discrimination, everything that this group really knows, as well as some developmental challenges. They're risk-taking, they're not thinking things happen to them. But it's also important to talk about the transition from adolescent care to adult care and the challenges within that, as well as being exposed to ARVs for a long period of time and what are those challenges. And the importance of youth-friendly support has been talked about all day here and is really critical to remove those barriers on adherence. And I don't want to leave this without talking about U equals U, because it is really important for us to work through the barriers on adherence so that our young people can really live this U equals U freeing phenomenon where if you're undetectable, you're untransmittable. And it's really up to us to really educate them about that possibility and encourage adherence, not only for themselves, but for the public health. I'm going to turn it over to Dr. Stranek to talk to us about prevention.